Welcome to another informative series brought to you by Autruo. The last time, we analyzed an equivalent circuit diagram using nominal T method. An equivalent phasor diagram was derived while making reference to the circuit. In the same vein too, we used the phasor diagram to prove some mathematical formula. Finally, we used the formula derived to solve medium transmission line using nominal T method. In today's series 2, we will continue to analyze nominal T transmission lines using ABCD parameters. So without any further ado, let's get started.
The ABCD parameters are also known as transmission line parameters or chain parameters. These parameters are used to characterize linear electrical networks, particularly transmission lines. That is because they provide a convenient way to analyze the behavior of these lines in terms of voltage and current.
That said, ABCD parameters are usually represented in a two-port network model, and we all know that. In electronics or electrical, a two-port network can be said to be a kind of four-terminal network or quadrupole that connects to external circuits. A two-port network model is used in mathematical circuit analysis techniques to isolate portions of larger circuits. A two-port network is regarded as a black box with its properties specified by a matrix of numbers.
The network is usually described by a 2x2 square matrix of complex numbers. The common models that are used are referred to as Z parameters, Y parameters, H parameters, G parameters, and ABCD parameters. These are all limited to linear networks since an underlying assumption of their derivation is that any given circuit condition is a linear superposition of various short circuit and open circuit conditions. They are usually expressed in matrix notation, and they establish relations between variables. Examples of circuits analyzed as two ports are filters, matching networks, transmission lines, transformers, and small signal models for transistors, such as the hybrid pi model, etc. The analysis of passive two-port networks is an outgrowth of reciprocity theorems first derived by Lorentz.
That said, we can consider these as the formula of ABCD parameters. That is VS equals AVR plus BIR, and IS equals CVR plus DIR. However, in order to maintain some bit of accuracy when using these mathematical models, it is important to note that transmission lines are classified into three types based on the length and voltage of the transmission lines. These are short transmission lines, medium transmission lines, and long transmission lines. It is important to note that the formula for these ABCD parameters will change based on the length of the transmission line. And of course, it is something that we should expect, since certain phenomena such as corona discharge and Ferranti effect only come into play when dealing with long transmission lines. These will be looked at in the coming series. Overall, ABCD parameters of a transmission line provide the link between the supply and the receiving end voltages and current when considering the elements to be linear in nature.
So basically, in layman's terms, ABCD parameters basically describe the mathematical relation between the sending end and the receiving end voltages and currents.
And it is on that note that we will start deriving the equations of the ABCD parameter. Again, since we are considering deriving the equation for a nominal T-power transmission line, then we can easily refer to the previous series. That is using equation 3 and equation 7 respectively. That is, the voltage of the capacitance VC is equal to the receiving end voltage VR plus the receiving end current IR multiplied by Z all over 2. For the second one, we will be considering equation 7, that is, the sending end voltage VS equal to the capacitance voltage VC plus the sending end current IS multiplied by Z all over 2 equation 7. Of course, when we applied Kirchhoff current law at node A, the sending end current IS will equal to the receiving end current IR plus the current flowing through the capacitance IC. By Ohm's law, the current flowing through the capacitance IC will equal to the sending end current IS minus the receiving end current IR, equation 8. Now we can consider the whole terminations here as Y, which is the admittance, equation 9. Now we can further manipulate the current flowing through the capacitance IC by substituting equation 3 into equation 9. With that, we will have our equation has the current flowing through the capacitance IC equal to open brackets, the receiving end voltage VR, plus the receiving end current IR multiplied by Z over 2 close brackets, and further multiplied by Y, which is the admittance equation 10. Now we can also substitute equation 8 into equation 10. That is, the sending end current, IS, minus the receiving end current, IR, equal to open bracket. The receiving end voltage, VR, plus the receiving end current, IR, multiplied by the impedance all over 2, close bracket all, multiplied by the admittance Y. So when we expand, we will be having these. The sending end current IS minus the receiving end current IR equal to the admittance of the receiving end voltage YVR plus the admittance of the receiving end current and impedance all over 2. So when we simplify this, we will have this here, which is equation 11.
Also, since we now have the value of the current flowing through the capacitance already, we can easily substitute equation 3 into equation 7. Now, the sending end voltage VS equal to the receiving end voltage VR plus the receiving end current IR multiplied by the impedance all over 2 plus the sending end current IS multiplied by the impedance all over 2 equation 12. Again, because we now have the sending end current IS, then we can substitute for the sending end current IS in equation 12. So we will substitute equation 11 into equation 12. Now, the sending end voltage VS will equal to the receiving end voltage VR plus the receiving end current multiplied by impedance all over 2, plus open bracket admittance multiplied by the receiving end voltage YVR, plus the receiving end current IR open bracket. So 1 plus admittance impedance all over 2 close brackets and close brackets multiplied by impedance all over 2. The simplification of the above will equal to this here. Also, the above can further be written again like this. Again, on the receiving end current IR side, we can combine the two impedances and strike them out, and then we will have this here.
Now, when we go back to our ABCD parameter matrices again, which state that the sending end voltage VS is equal to A multiplied by the receiving end voltage VR, plus the B multiplied by the receiving end current IR equal to the receiving end voltage VR, and the sending end current IS equal to C multiplied by receiving end voltage VR, plus D multiplied by the receiving end current IR. Now, when we look at our equations there, the sending end voltage VS will be our A and B, where A will be equal to this and B will be equal to this, while the sending end current is will be equal to our C and D, where C is equal to this, and finally, D will be equal to this.
Based on those, then we can simulate different conditions. Now let's consider that the receiving end of the transmission line is open circuited, that is, the receiving end current IR is zero. With these, we would end up with two ratios. Now let's see what I meant. On the first side, when we apply an open circuit condition to the ABCD parameter, then the sending end voltage VS is equal to A multiplied by the receiving end voltage VR plus B multiplied by zero. With these, A will equal to the ratio of the sending end voltage VS all over the receiving end voltage VR. With these, we can say that A will be a dimensionless parameter, while on the other equation, and when we apply to ABCD parameter of a transmission line, then C will further be equal to the ratio of the sending end current IS all over the receiving end voltage VR. So, from A, I can get the ratio of voltages, which in turn would indicate whether I got the intended drop or extra drop or even gain, which is due to Ferranti effect in the voltage. Similarly, the admittance offered by the network can be gotten also.
Now, when considering the receiving end current IR of the transmission line to be short-circuited, that said, the receiving end voltage VR will be zero. So when a short-circuit condition is applied to the ABCD parameter of a transmission line, then the sending end voltage VS will equal to A multiplied by the receiving end voltage VR plus B multiplied by the receiving end current IR. And when the receiving end voltage VR is equal to zero, then the summation of this mathematical equation will be B equal to the ratio of sending end voltage all over the receiving end current. Also, the same can be said for the second equation. The receiving end voltage VR is equal to zero too. So the resultant of these will be D equal to the ratio of sending end current all over the receiving end current. From B, we get the amount of impedance offered by the circuit. And from D, the current gain loss ratio is obtained. Once measured, they are almost fixed for a network. This is very useful in designing and simulating power system networks. So when I design a line up to a certain voltage limit, and if I can draw a varying amount of power within the limit, how much power should be supplied when considering all the losses and drops and impedance. This can be easily predicted using these approaches. The reverse can also be done in ideal cases of constant load. So, when the power transfer capabilities are known, there are numerous possibilities that we can do with it.
As seen in the matrix earlier, for a symmetrical network, A will equal to D, while for a reciprocal network, AD minus BC will equal to 1. In order to confirm, when we take the like terms of these, only one will be remaining. Now we can easily use those formulas to solve a transmission line problem using the ABCD parameter. For example, a three-phase transmission line has the following: resistance, inductance, and capacitance per phase of 8 ohms, 0.15 Henry, and 0.87 microfarads respectively, and delivers a load of 40 megawatts at 132 kilovolts at a power factor of 0.8 PF lag. Determine the efficiency and regulation of the line using ABCD parameter of a nominal T transmission line.
Looking at that problem there, we know that our frequency is 50 Hz, resistance per phase is 8 ohms, inductance per phase is 0.15 Henry, and capacitance per phase is equal to 0.87 microfarads. The receiving end power is 40 megawatts. The receiving end voltage is 132 kilowatts, and the phase angle is 36.86 degrees. So in order to get the phase voltage, the receiving end voltage VR is equal to 132,000 divided by root 3. This will equal to 76,210.23 volts. We can also calculate the receiving end current IR2, that is 40 megawatts divided by 3 times 76,210.23 times 0.8. This will equal to 218.69 amperes, again because the phase angle is already known. Then we can say that the current flowing through the line is 218.69 at an angle of minus 36.86 degrees.
Now let's calculate the impedances of the line, that is, resistance R plus J omega L, where omega is 2 pi frequency, that is 8 plus J open bracket 2 times pi time 50 times 0.15 close bracket. The resultant of these will be 8 plus J 47.12, and when we convert from triangle to polar form, the impedances will be 47.794 at an angle of 80.36. The admittance of the line can also be calculated too. Again, we know that admittance is J omega C. If further simplified, J2 times pi times frequency times the capacitance, that is 2 times pi times 50 times 0.87 times 10 raised to power minus 6. This will equal to 2.733 times 10 raised to power minus 4. And because in a capacitor, current lead voltage by 90 degrees, our phase angle here will be at angle 90 degrees.
Now that virtually all the values we need are available, we can now begin to calculate the value of our ABCD parameters. We know that A is also equal to D, which is as a result of this here, that is 1 plus admittance multiplied by the impedance all over 2. So 1 plus open bracket, 2.733, times 10 raised to power minus 4 at an angle of 90 degrees. Close bracket, multiplied by 47.794 at an angle of 80.36 degrees close bracket, and all over 2. This will equal to 1.306 times 10 raised to power minus 2 at an angle of 170.36 degrees all over 2. The resultant of this will be 1 plus 6.53 times 10 raised to power minus 3 at an angle of 170.36 degrees. So in order for us to resolve this, then there is a need for us to convert from polar form to triangle form. That is 1 plus open bracket minus 0.064 plus J 0.009. Now we can now resolve this now, which will now equal to 0.993 plus J 0.00109. Finally, when we convert from triangle to polar form, A and D will now be 0.993 at an angle of 0.062.
For B, and when we look at the derived matrix again, B is equal to impedance plus admittance multiplied by impedance squared all over 4. That is, open bracket 47.794 at an angle of 80.36 degrees, plus open bracket 2.733 times 10, raised to power minus 4 at an angle of 90 degrees close bracket, multiplied by open bracket 47.794 at angle of 80.36 degrees close bracket all raised to power 2 and all over 4. When we simplified those, we will have this, and when multiplied the right-hand side, we will now have 0.42 at angle 250.72 degrees all over 4, and plus 47.794 at angle 80.36. Also, when we divide the right-hand side by 4, we will have 0.15605 at an angle of 250.72 degrees, and plus the left-hand side, which is 47.794 at an angle of 80.36 degrees. So in order to be able to add them both, we will convert from polar form to triangle form. After conversion, we will have this, and the summation of both will be 7.952 plus J 46.972. Now when we convert from triangle to polar form, B will now be 47.64 at an angle of 80.39 degrees.
Getting C is going to be pretty much straightforward, because we already have admittance, so C is 2.733 times 10 raised to power 4 at an angle of 90 degrees. Now in order to get the sending end voltage Vs, which is AVR plus BIR, we can begin to slot our value since we already have them calculated out. When calculated, the value of the sending end voltage Vs is equal to 8320.17 plus J 7257.39. Also, when converted to polar form, it will be 83545.98 at an angle of 4.98 degrees. The same can also be said for the sending end current IS. When all the data is slotted in, the sending end current IS will be equal to 173.88 minus J109.25. When converted to polar form, the sending end current IS will equal to 205.35 at an angle of minus 32.14 degrees amperes, which means the current lags behind the voltage.
Now, the voltage regulation of the line can be determined since we also have the data we need, which are the sending end current and the sending end voltages. So using this formula here, the receiving end voltage at no load VRNL minus receiving end voltage at full load VRFL all over the receiving end voltage at full load multiplied by 100. Again, since we don't have the value of no load, we can apply the formula we proved earlier here. So that will be the absolute of sending voltage VS all over the absolute of A minus the absolute of the receiving end voltage VR all over the absolute of the receiving end voltage VR multiplied by 100. The resultant of these numbers here will be 10.39%. The efficiency of the line can also be obtained using these equations here. That is, the power received all over the power at the sending end multiplied by 100.
Now, before we can be able to get the voltage regulation of the line, we will need to have an idea of the power factor at the sending end, so we will combine both the angles of the sending end voltage Vs and the sending end current Is together. That is cos 4.98 degrees plus 32.14 degrees. This will equal to cos 37.12, which will now equal to 0.79 lagging. Now, in order to determine the total power at the sending end, this will now be 3 multiplied by the sending end voltage, multiplied by the sending end current, multiplied by the sending end angle. The mathematical summation of these will equal to 40.6 megawatts. So when we divide the power received PR all over the power at the sending end PS multiplied by 100, this will equal to 98.37%. And that is it for today's series. In the coming series, we will be looking at long transmission lines, the equivalent circuits, the phasor diagram, and the formula are all going to be looked at. So I hope you have learned something new today. See you in the next series.